Hello viewers, as I told you earlier that again we'll be back to our CRE class. This is your teacher Roger Michira, ready to take you through CRE Form 3. And we are still looking at the topic of the Holy Spirit. Now, remember, in our previous class, we did look at the gifts of the Holy Spirit. We talked of the gift of wisdom, the gift of knowledge, the gift of faith, the gift of love, right? Speaking in tongues, interpreting tongues, healing, performing miracles, and also the gift of prophecy. Now, today's class, we get to look at manifestation of the Holy Spirit. How is the Holy Spirit manifested in the church today? And also, how can you know that this person is being has the gift of the Holy Spirit, right? The criteria of discerning the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Now, those are two things we're going to look at today. Manifestation, how do you know that this person has been manifested by the Holy Spirit? Rather, this person has the Holy Spirit, has the gifts of the Holy Spirit, and also, how is the Holy Spirit manifested in the church today? Welcome all, and let us learn. I've already introduced the lesson objectives. I've already stated the lesson objectives. Let us get straight to our lesson. Now, manifestation of the Holy Spirit in the church and Christians today. How do you know that the Holy Spirit is in the church? How do you know that the Holy Spirit is manifested in Christians? One, the gifts of the Holy Spirit have been manifested in churches today. We see these manifestations through people possessing the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Now, the manifestation is revealed when people or when Christians get to possess the gifts of the Holy Spirit. Now, how do you know that? One, leaders in church have displayed the gift of wisdom. Remember, wisdom, this is the deep understanding, right? You have the deep understanding on the word of God, right? You have that deep understanding on what God wants us to do, right? So leaders in church have displayed the gift of wisdom. Hey, yes, what about the gift of preaching? Remember that those people who can preach till you see heaven has come down, right? Now, preachers and Christian ministers have been casting out demons and performing healing through preaching also. And also, there are reported cases of interpretation of tongues and gifts of prophecy in churches today. We have prophets, right? Talk of Prophet Award. Yes, he has been prophesying, right? There will become a tsunami, the issue of earthquakes. Good. We have got prophets in church today. And also, people were able to interpret tongues. Now, also, the gifts of the Holy Spirit are manifested through healing, prophecy, gift of discernment, right? Boldness in preaching and casting out demons among others. For example, who is bold enough to stand here and start preaching? Right? Anyone? You see that? You must have the gift of boldness, right? You must be bold for you to stand here and preach, or you stand at the pulpit and preach to people. Christians also, the issue of helping the poor, that's the gift of love. If you don't have the gift of love, do you think you can help someone who is poor? That generosity? Very rare. Can I now get to the criteria for discerning gifts of the Holy Spirit? How do you discern? Right? Christians who have the Holy Spirit are guided by Jesus and have certain characteristics. How do you know that this person is guided by Jesus? How do you know that this person has the gift of the Holy Spirit? One, they will confess that Jesus is Lord. Yes? I love Jesus. Jesus is Lord, my Savior. Right? You must have to confess that Jesus is Lord. That's why you see, when people are giving testimonies in church, they always say, praise God, church, that I'm saved and I love Jesus. Jesus is Lord. Now, they are confessing, right? That is one way of discerning the gift of the Holy Spirit. That's the criteria. And another way is that they cannot say a curse, right? These people who have the gift of the Holy Spirit, they cannot say to you a curse. They cannot curse you. They speak the truth. They worship God and behave in accordance with Jesus' teaching. These are people who speak the truth, right? They do according to Jesus' teachings. They are led by the Holy Spirit and are known by the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Yes, they have the fruit of love. They have the fruit of joy. They have the fruit of peace. They have patience. They are kind. They are humble. Right? They have the fruit of the Holy Spirit. But later again, we get to look at what are some of these fruits of the Holy Spirit. Lastly, they do not do sinful acts such as sexual immorality. You cannot find them. The issue of fornication, the issue of adultery, the issue of incest, you cannot get them there. They do not practice idolatry and sorcery. Good. The issue of visiting mediums. Right? Good. Now, that is the criteria of discerning the gift of the Holy Spirit. Now, class, for our task, can we get to explain how the gifts of the Holy Spirit are manifested in the church today? And as always, this is Elim TV, your favorite learning channel. Thank you all for attending our class today. Let us see you in the next class in the topic number 6. Thank you all and see you.